Think running a day spa is all massages and relaxation?
There is nothing relaxing about owning a day spa.
But we're here to help. Siri spa owners know that being in the spa business isn't for the weak.
It takes hard work, planning, and just a bit of luck.
We should know because we've owned a successful day spa for over 20 years. Now we're opening up our playbooks and giving you the business insights to run your day spa rather than letting it run you. This is a Spapreneur podcast with Lynn Graves and Ramona Rice.
Ho, 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 Spapreneur.
And happy holidays to everyone.
All the holidays.
We got a little caught up in the holidays, and I'm sorry, we weren't here the last couple of weeks. Actually, we were, but Mona came back, and then she got sick, and
I caught the crud.
Yeah, and it's been going around our office, and it's just been kind of a cray-cray time
for
us.
Well, and Thanksgiving, I just got back from being in England for 2 weeks.
And I have some kind of sad news to tell everybody. Our little demon dog, we had to say goodbye to her. She was old, and she was the one I was yelling at and has the adoring eyes, and I posted her on Facebook because I wanted y'all to see her. And she was a wonderful, sweet, and kind dog, and she gave us 13 years. And so please don't be sad for us because it was a good long run with her. And you're not going to hear about us saying, oh, she scratched at the floor. But now we got the little black demon running around here, which we don't talk about very often.
Psycho dog.
She is a psycho dog. This dog is, I'm telling you, she's freaking out of her mind.
She hops like a kangaroo.
And at night, she she growls at you like a friggin' pirate. So it's like, really? Really? And she'll wag her tail while she's growling. It's like, oh, yeah, look, she just stood up and go, oh, I heard my voice.
Yeah, so anyway.
So we are sorry at the passing of Alto, but we wanted to let you know why we won't be talking about her anymore. And I've had several friends that had to say goodbye to pets at this time of year, and there's just a rash of it. But all of them have lived long lives, and we understand if you have a pet that they're family members, so give them extra hugs and love and a little extra treat tonight.
Yes, very good. And other news, massage envy. Good God.
You know, I when it came out on national news, and if you've not heard it, and this
There's no way you haven't heard it.
Well, really haven't. Henry had not heard it.
Oh, my God.
And I told him about it. So, and this was before they came out with Matt Lauer, which is sad enough on its own because I felt like Matt was a family member of mine. So they did a report on massage envy. If you've not heard it, go online, listen to it. I think that it's skewed. I think that it is news that they are sensationalizing. And I'm very sad about this. Yes, are they someone that we don't want to be better than us? Yeah, I don't want them better. But this is not how it's going to go down for me. So after listening to the report,
Let's summarize the report really fast. It was a BuzzFeed investigation, okay. 180 alleged incidents of sexual assault, massage therapist assaulting women on the table.
Yes, and one guy pled guilty to 7 counts of it.
There was another guy.
I know that
3.
One of the people that was talking about that he did something that another therapist did something to her. And that nothing was done about it. And she went to the news. Happened in Virginia. Mm-hmm. Because I remember when the report came out.
Right, in Richmond.
But this is the part that bothered me the most. Not the most. I mean, you know, shame on that guy who
shame on anybody who violates anybody else.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Because now we're all painted with the same brush as mm-hmm. this person. However, there was a lady who said, I was laying on the table and he pushed my panties down and massaged down there. And I'm thinking, now, wait a minute. Did he move your panties aside to work on the sacrum or something? What was there more to this story, or did it really go down the way she said?
See, I think this is a prime example of communicating with your clients. You know, like because he, if he were smart, I think he really violated her.
From
the way
don't
she described
know.
Way I she, do not well, know. I either way, she felt violated. That's
she
all,
did.
That's all that matters.
And here's my side of it.
He should have just talked to her and said, I need
Absolutely.
To move this out of the way. Here's
yes.
why. And if you give a medical reason why, and they yes. still say no, you need to work around that.
Absolutely.
Because they have the right to say no.
So here's what I did. I went in on Monday morning and I wrote a memo. And the memo is basically about intention and perception. If you have the intent that you are working down the back or along a bra line and they have their bra on and you need to get to that area, you say to them, little client, I would like to work this area here. Touch it over the sheet. It would be easier if I could slide under here. But if you're not comfortable with that, I won't do so. See, that's intention, and you communicate. However, if you don't say that, what is their perception now? They might have the perception of, what the hell? What are they
and
doing
I
down
think
there?
Rightfully so. So yes. You cannot assume. I think that's number one, to save your butt. But number two is this. If you have a day spa kind of like ours where we have multiple people working, you need to have a policy immediately. Thank the Lord, or a discussion. Yeah, because we've had it where past massage therapists have been accused of sexual like favors in the rooms and all, and we've had to have meetings about it, and it yes. didn't happen in our place, but...
Yes, and... I also, I addressed this with all of my therapists and put it out there with all of them, but I thought it was also most important that I wrote it, to myself.
Yeah.
I've been doing this for 22 years and I need to remember that just because I'm comfortable with the body, that other people may not be comfortable with the body. So I needed that to look at myself. I also ended that memo by saying, we take the high road. Yes, we dog a little bit on massage envy and the way they treat the therapist out there. But that's between colleagues. But we're not going to tell clients, bad, don't go to massage envy, bad. They're terrible people. There are some good therapists that work there, and they're being painted by that brush. That's not fair to them. You take that high road, and you say not all therapists and most therapists do this with a pure heart.
And we're governed by Board of Nursing. We have all these
accreditation. We are, yes.
Just use that background.
So you take
education.
That high road.
Take the high road. Yeah, it's not
Please.
Worth bashing massage envy. But at the same time, too, if you have a practice with multiple service providers, whether it's a bunch of facial, estheticians, or nail techs, whatever it is, massage therapists, mm-hmm. you have a policy and you make it clear that if someone's accused of something, you don't handle it internally. You have to get... You have
okay,
to.
Okay, this is what happened with us. We, and this is where Massage Envy went wrong.
Majorly.
This is where they major went wrong, was their front desk didn't take it seriously.
Yep.
Even a minor complaint. You listen to that client and you ask yourself, why are they saying it? Because it was perception or perhaps something went wrong. You listen to this crap. We had a therapist, I don't think I mentioned this before in any of the podcasts. I won't mention her name. And she worked on a client 4 days later. And this particular therapist I found aggravating because she was old enough. She was only a few years younger than me. Delightful in personality, but she would not listen. She would not. She was unteachable. She had her way of doing things, and she didn't want to change. So she was very, very aggressive in her massages. A lot of people like that. However, she got hold of a young lady one day. 4 days later, that lady showed up in our office and she was black across her sacrum, pure black. That was 4 days later. She had already been to the doctor and she had extended to the therapist. That's a little deep. And this therapist did not listen to her. I immediately, after taking pictures of this blackness on her back, contacted that therapist, said, I can no longer have you here. And then I turned it over to our regulating board, the only time in 22 years I've done this, and I turned it over to them for investigation and discipline. I did that to protect the client, and I did that to protect us.
And it's the right thing to do.
It was the right thing to do. In the end, she was exonerated. I'm not sure how. I don't care. That's not my business at this point.
But she at least has that there's always the little nub says she was investigated.
Yes,
that stays on the record.
Let me make this little snide side comment where Massage Envy says they go and they investigate and check all references and everything else. Well, they sure as hell don't do it in our area because this girl went back to Massage Envy, started working for them, never contacted me. And there's several that they've done this and never asked why. Why is she no longer working there?
Yeah.
So now it's their problem, not mine. I only wish her the best in life, but you got to cover your butt. So That's really not what we wanted to talk about today.
But it's such an important topic, and we know you guys are talking about it. And we haven't addressed it yet in our Facebook community, which has been hopping.
Hey, hey, hey. I do need to say this, because one of our therapists actually works for Massage Envy also. Mm-hmm. And she told me that reporters have been coming in and calling and getting on the tables and trying to get some kind of dirt on massaging. And I'm thinking to myself, they're not stopping there. They're getting on other tables too. Be uber cautious. If you don't know this client and you're doing gluteal or adductor work or something, you talk it through. You explain why. You use medical terms. I don't like this witch hunt atmosphere that's starting to feel like it's becoming. We're good people. We do good work. We want to bring balance to people's lives. So just be cautious. Okay? Enough of that nonsense. Enough. Okay?
Happy holidays, everyone.
Okay. So, on that note, I've been going back and listening to the last two podcasts, one of them being, you know, the no-no massages and what you should and should not do. But we left it with, we were going to do an open house.
Oh, yeah.
And we were getting prepared for the open house.
And she did the open house while I was away.
Yeah. Let me point this crap out.
Look,
she went to England.
Okay, my trip.
2 weeks.
Okay, my trip was planned.
I do not care.
Months before you decided.
I am an old woman.
Well, that was,
I forget this
shit. That was stupid.
And I put the date down on a good date, a Wednesday. Folks, I am never doing that shit again. I think I put that on the live Facebook feed. Oh, my God. So, if you want to know if Ramona's methods work and you're like on the fence of whether or not to get on the bandwagon with her, this is how it went down. In the end, the catering came up to about $1,000, and Lyric and I stupidly looked at each other and said, hey, we can do the cooking.
Lynn doesn't like to cook, by the way.
If you listen to a podcast, you'll know that I hate cooking, but I did it, and he did his part. And then we went and bought some goodies and cut them all up and all. So we had a good fair share. It was raining that day, all day. And I said to my group, you know, I don't think we're going to have a very big turnout because it's raining, it's dreary, time has changed, dark. They started showing up at 10 o'clock in the morning. Oh, doesn't it go all day? I went, no, it starts at 5. Oh, I thought it was all day long. No, it starts at 5. Go away. When they started showing up at 5, I have 4,000 square feet, 4,000 folks. And I put the food in the furthest corner I could because it had a back door. They came in, said hello, signed for their tickets so that they could be part of the drawing. Where is the food? And went straight for it. Ramona, the food was gone in 1 hour.
Well.
1 hour.
Did you ever count how many people came through?
There were like 250.
That's pretty good for an open house.
On a rainy, nasty, yucky day.
And here's the thing, kids. We didn't really advertise that much. I advertised on Facebook a little bit.
Well, you obviously advertised enough.
Well, I advertised it really well because I know what I'm doing. And
if you go to our website.
And we only sent one email out about it.
Okay, guys. If you go to our website, you can scroll down. The lady named Mia.
Oh, on our Facebook page, yeah.
Says, I saw a Facebook ad, quote, unquote. I'm like, what the hell? What does she mean she saw an ad? I've never been to De-Stress before, but I thought I'll go and I can at least get some free food, okay? And lo and behold, I got there and it was wonderful. Read it for yourselves because this is the gospel truth. By the time 1 hour hit and we had mass mobs lined up, it was crazy. I had my glass of wine. I was hiding in my office with two of my peeps going, my girlfriends, and saying, oh my God, I'm just going to stay here. I'm not going out. They can do the job themselves. And they did. Everybody ran. And still, the therapist drank. Little buzzards.
Okay.
Little buzzards. I told them not to.
Here's a couple of things. Number one, you should not have hidden in your office. You should have been yelling at this therapist going, no drink.
I was so tired.
No.
I was so tired.
Okay, no. I'm going to say this right
Mommy
now.
Mommy was tired.
This is, and she's telling me this now. The first time I've heard about it is now.
But I didn't get drunk. Other than one of my Asian guys who gets really red in the face. But you
no, it's irresponsible. That's not the purpose of this thing.
I didn't know it till it was done.
Well, you need to go to all of them and say, this is inappropriate.
Yes, well.
No, and you know what? I mean, it's too far gone now for me to do it, but I would.
She's the F word.
But it's ridiculous. No, because the focus, here's why.
You hear her getting on to me?
Focus is, and I'm telling this to you guys too, is the focus of the open house was not for them. They're about to have their own party next week. They get their own party that costs us damn near more than this open house.
Well, it'll cost us about $2,000.
Yes. Okay. They get their party. So that's why I'm like going, no, this was for the clients.
You know what, though? They had fun. The clients are still raving.
How many appointments were made? Do you know?
I don't have the count now. I do know that in the past 2 weeks, we've had clients coming in that we've never seen before. There were so many people there that we did not know.
The Facebook ad cost me $50, y'all.
It was crazy.
$50. All I did was we set up an event on Facebook.
And remember, and our house fairy came in, our housekeeper.
We love her, the house fairy.
Yeah, we call her the house fairy.
Yeah.
And she came in and she said, my brother's a realtor and he's down the road and he doesn't come into you guys, but he saw the Facebook ad. Yeah, obviously it worked, folks. So it
leads us into something we're going to talk about in this episode. The rest of the episode, we're going to be talking about things that you should be doing for the holidays right now. If you've gone through a 31-day challenge, some of it may be familiar. You'll be okay to get a refresher. But one thing I want to mention really fast is we have a new program coming up. It starts in January. It's called the Six Pillars Program. Mm-hmm. And it's a 90-day, basically 12 weeks where you're working with me and we work on the six pillars of day spa success.
Think of it as a more detailed, more concise 31-day challenge that's going to take your business and move it to a whole new level and something that you will keep with you always. I mean, it's your roadmap, folks. We talked about this a long time ago. You need a roadmap.
And it's going to be an investment for you in your massage, in your career. Yeah. You need tax deductions, number one.
And two, if you're whining, saying, I can't afford it.
You
either add in more clients or stop drinking Starbucks. Invest in yourself.
Yeah.
Please, for God's sake.
I originally was going to price this at about $700, and it's worth that. It actually is worth more. You're going to make more than that with this program. But because it's the first time we've done it, and because I want to make sure it's really, really affordable for our spapreneurs, the price is not even like half of that. So just go on.
Mona's watching me do some nonsense, which is why she keeps hesitating.
Well, she's writing stuff down. I don't know what she's doing.
Now she's giving me a pin.
This is crazy.
Folks, we are amateurs. Can you tell we are amateurs?
We can tell John to take this out, but I don't want to because I want them to know this is what we do. No, the price is...
we're real people.
Yeah, we have a payment plan for a six pillars program, and we've got a one-time price. And it comes with... you get weekly calls with me. You get lessons. You get worksheets. You get a whole bunch of stuff. And it's just, you know what? You can either continue to kind of piecemeal your plan, or you can work with someone for...
Make a choice.
For 22 years.
Yeah.
I have helped her grow her business.
Really? Make a choice. Not all of you are ready for it. You're not emotionally there. And I get that. But there's a group of you out there that are ready to make a change. And I'm reading it on Facebook. I'm seeing it. You stand up and you make that choice. You make that investment in yourself. I can't say it any more strongly than that, because here's the joke. I think we put this on the live Facebook thing. We did this 31-day challenge and I was all into it. And mind you, I've got so much going on in my life right now. And I was caught up in Alto also with her, you know, knowing that she was going to pass because we knew about the tumor. And, all of a sudden, I said, Mona, I don't think I have any hint cards.
We totally forgot to order them. I'm not even kidding.
So we haven't quite done it yet, but we're going to take that massive email list we have. We're going to create a email hint card so they can print it and put it out there. So
we're trying new things for our spa this year, not because we plan to, but because of necessity.
Hey, but you know what? We have the ability for a backup plan.
Yeah.
But okay.
So let's talk about the hint card for a minute. If you didn't take our challenge, you don't know what that is. So hint card, we've mentioned the podcast before. It is an idea that Lynn came up with because my stepfather, he is great and he's generous, but he's one of those, if you tell him what you want,
you won't get it.
You won't get it. It's hilarious.
Except he told me what he wanted for Christmas, and as he's telling me, I sat there and ordered it. It's the new bread baking thing, because I want good bread.
Yeah, but
the man makes killer
bread.
That's
a gift for us, really.
Yeah, really.
Yeah,
it is.
We're so anyway, free.
So we decided to do hint, hint.
So the idea is you stick a hint, hint card. You can order them on Vistaprint, really inexpensive, and you just say, hint, hint, I would love him to put your business's name
on
there.
On there.
And then give it to the clients, especially
and
your
folks,
female clients.
Go out to lunch and lay them on the tables for the servers and everybody else. Don't be shy.
And include like a decent tip for that server and put it in there.
Jeez,
because guess what? Waiters and waitresses, everyone has money.
I pull up to McDonald's. Oh, here's a hint, hint card too.
Yeah. And you just put them out there. And what happens is that women and men, they lay them for people to find like in sock drawers or car.
Yeah.
The mailbox, wherever.
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. I can't tell you how many people come in even long after Christmas or long after I've done something and say, I've been carrying this around forever and I just finally got around to it. Great.
Great. And so they just use it for themselves.
Hey, you know what? The cards are doing them no good sitting in the office. So get those damn things out there.
Yeah.
One way or the other.
Yeah. Take an afternoon, guys. This is something I really suggest. I saw a lot of you with Black Friday getting disappointed because no one came in.
I told you.
You didn't tell them to come in, too. Like, a lot of them didn't send email blasts out. They didn't invite them in. You didn't give them a reason to come in. So go see them.
Yeah. And didn't we, maybe on the live, no, I wrote this on Facebook. Yeah. So some of you may not have seen this.
We don't worry about Black Friday.
Well, I used to sweat. From Thanksgiving until a week before Christmas, I'd be like, oh my God, nobody's buying anything. Here's what happens, at least for us, and I read that a few of you go through this also. Black Friday, we don't get hardly anybody coming in for that. And what they are, they're out in the malls and they're doing other things. They wait until the last 15 days until Christmas, and all of a sudden you get a flood of people coming in.
Yeah.
So don't get discouraged. Keep the positive mode out there. But there are things you can do. I like what one of my clients, a good friend of mine, he opened a dance studio, Rick. Mm-hmm. And now he got to me too late, but I held on to this because I thought this will be fun for later in the year. In there, in the envelope, he has a letter saying, I have a great idea for you for Christmas. How about bringing your group over here? We will cater some food and we will give fun dance lessons.
Fun.
Yes.
And you could totally do that. We've done that in the past because our facility is so big where we actually had an entire doctor's group come in. They brought everybody in on Saturday. So we closed for Saturday just for this group. Mm-hmm. We arranged for catering. They paid for the catering, but we arranged it so they didn't have to worry about it. They just showed up. I had a little, like, I set up one of the rooms as like a lounge area, and they wanted to watch girly movies and hang out with each other in their pajamas while some of them got massage, some of them got facial, some of them got pedicures, and they were there all day. Easiest money we've ever made, because guess what? I didn't have, and then our lobby was still open to take gifts.
Yeah,
gifts.
And they did that like 3 years in a row, and then they changed it up.
Yeah, because they wanted to change it.
So how does that apply to you? So make a really, you go over to Office Max, and they have this pretty Christmas paper, and you print something up. I have an excellent idea for you, because believe it or not, not all offices have already bought everything. And then you walk around to some of the businesses that are near you, some that look like they'd be fun to walk into. And at first, they're going to look at you and think, oh God, here comes the solicitor. And they're going to have the mean face on them. But the moment you sweetly say, hi, I'm one of the local massage therapists, and I just want to give you this letter in case, you know, y'all haven't come up with your Christmas idea. Smile, say it sweetly. I guarantee you, the moment you say the word massage therapist, they go, oh my God, I
even
need
better,
that.
If you have like a logo shirt, like we've told you, whether it's a polo or just a regular t-shirt that has your logo on it, says massage on it.
And put on a holiday hat. Yeah, put on a Santa
or get
hat
one of those
and make
cute,
it
like
fun.
Christmas fascinator things.
And take some candy canes and give it to them at the same time.
Yeah, or like little bags of candy. You can get those at the dollar store.
And here's what's really good. Normally, even people that are like bah humbug during the rest of the year are all of a sudden, I'm so happy.
I'm so happy.
So do this and just go out and pass it out. Even if you only get one client from there.
Better than nothing.
Hey. All you did was waste time.
Yeah.
That was it. Mm-hmm. That was time well spent. Actually, you planted seeds.
Yeah. The holidays really are about planting seeds. Like, I see constantly, not in the Spotpreneur Facebook group because we shun this kind of information, but, and we've corrected y'all and we've educated y'all on this, but gift certificates. Let's talk about those for a minute. We go into detail in the 31 Day Challenge. We have a new ebook guide that I will link to the episode all about winning with gift certificates. But here's the biggest thing. I see this all the time. They don't come in during my expiration date. I feel like I'm giving a free a massage and they come in 6 months later. I saw one. I could not believe this. She was like, I do a buy one, get one, but they have to use the get one within 2 weeks. What?
Yeah, that's too short of a time when people's lives are too busy. And first of all, let me explain once again why we do not have an expiration date. I want you to really let this sink in and think about this, folks. I want them to come in. I don't want the quote unquote perceived free money from one that's not redeemed. That does me no good, none, because then I have no opportunity to get a repeat client.
And that's what gift certificates are. Gift certificates are paid testimonials. So all of you guys who are like complaining you never get testimonials or referrals, guess what gift certificates are? They are paid referrals, paid testimonials.
And ask them every time, please, can you go on the website? If you ask, they will do it.
And if you send them an email, which we go over in our email course, you know, because that's the reason why we have so many reviews, is we send that email out. It matters. And does everybody fill it out? No, but a good portion of them do, because we remind them.
For that reason, even with our new website and all, I think I'm going to keep Demand Force because it's unbiased. And we'll talk about this in the next episode a little bit, but they're unbiased. And that part of our company is so important.
It's our number one marketing tool by far. Like, you know, I see a lot of people out there, and a lot of good massage coaches are telling you guys, notice we mentioned Facebook ads once in this thing. I never say that's a solution to anything. The best thing you can do is get great testimonies, because people do research.
It is. It's truly the number one.
It really is. And DemandForce is not inexpensive. It is, you know, so it's not going to be good for you guys who are just starting out. But for my bigger day spas and you're ready to invest into something, it is an amazing program.
And we will talk about, like I said, a little bit of this in the next episode. But you get out of that mindset of if they come in 6 months to a year later that you're losing money.
You're not losing money. You already
got paid. Shame on you. You spent that money before they came in.
And again, in the free ebook, Winning with Gift Certificates, we go over this, but this is how we handle our gift certificate money. This is the way Rick Dupas, our chief financial officer, handles it for de-stress.
It's set aside.
Yeah, that's what he does. He has a separate account for the gift certificate money. So he takes out the portion that belongs to the business, and he'll keep an estimate. Because our independent contractors are on commission based, so he'll keep it at not the most expensive commission based, but usually an average.
Yeah,
and then
so we hold it in reserve, basically.
Right, and he has in a savings account that is an interest bearing savings account, so we're making money off of that. And then every quarter he'll take a portion of it out. Like a certain amount out. And these are numbers you have to play with yourself. And that money he'll put towards, like, again, like, you know, savings or other things we may need. And so it's like an instant war chest. But that money is not for us to go like, ooh, we have blah, blah, blah money. We go to go to vacation. No. And that's what you guys are doing.
My money.
It's not your money. The money that comes into your business is not yours. It belongs to the business. And it doesn't matter if you're a solo practitioner or you're like us with 30 of them and they're crazy. It belongs to the company first. So you have to get in that mindset. And until you get in that mindset, you will never be successful.
And here's what's really nice. With our gift certificate system, almost always try to get the name. We get the name of the person purchasing. We make sure we have their phone number.
And try to get the gift recipient as well.
And we try to get the gift recipient.
Because I have done this. Everybody says you lost a gift certificate and you cry because that's wasted money. Well, this way they can call and find it for them. And talk about great customer service.
But what's even more fun, you can go back in the next year, and when you're slow, you can start contacting some of these people and saying, hey, I noticed you purchased a gift certificate for blah, 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 and they've not used it yet. Perhaps you'd like to come in and use it yourself. This is an opportunity for you to get a repeat client. That's where your money is, folks. Not a one-time client. It's your repeat client.
Yeah, new clients are great and all, but you want those steady, like you want a client to be monogamous with you guys. And I say that with purpose. Like, it's fun to date around, but after a while you get tired of it and you want to be with your same person. You want those regular clients. You want them to come in week after week after week. And that is where the riches are, because here's what happens. They come in week after week, which is great. They start sending in people they love because they can't help but talk about it, especially if you're providing them real results. Like, if all of a sudden their skin clears up and they don't have crow's feet anymore, people are going to be like, what you doing?
Botox,
sure. But there are many spas that do that, you know. So, but, you know, or cupping or whatever. Or if you've got bad acne and you've got the microdermabrasion does so many things, guys.
Don't get me started. I got a facial this week. And I just, once again, if I were gay, Would be mine. Yeah, I love Kay.
It makes my skin so happy when her hands are doing whatever she does. So but this is important. So, and then these are the people that buy gift certificates from you to give to people.
And then when you get that person in and they see how wonderful and they realize, wow, that was a wonderful gift. And then they buy gift certificates and give it to others. Oh my God.
Or they buy a membership or a package. They come in regularly.
So folks, it really hone in on this. And if you're just going, this ain't for me, and I just don't believe that, and that's not the way it goes down.
Well, find another podcast.
No, because we want to help everybody we can, even if it's one little tiny thing. But you may as well go to Groupon.
You may as well. And
because
those
people, like Mona said, quite a few podcasts ago, they're loyal to Groupon. So if you go Groupon, you're going to get money in, and then they're going to leave. So So, all right.
We cannot talk about gift certificates enough. So, if you have not invested any time in gift certificates, there's still time. You can go to Staples or Office Max and get postcards printed really quickly. You can make paper ones. They do sell them.
Yeah, I got it. People want to know, why don't we have the card system? Because it'd be so much easier for it to register on our computers.
It would
be faster. Because the data, a lot of times, gets erased off the card. The cards are common. And I like to stand out.
Yeah,
something nice about
a paper.
Yeah, and there's something nice about a handwritten note, or there are some things that should never go out of fashion.
Also, real quick too, gift cards and gift certificates under federal law cannot expire within 5 years. That's a federal law, guys.
Oh, I didn't know that. Yeah. I don't care anymore.
Yeah,
this is the way we do it.
Yeah, so if nothing else, it's a federal law. But not offering gift certificates, you're leaving so much money off the table. It's not about right now. It's about what are you doing right this minute in December to feed January? Because here's what happens. I see so many of you get kind of busy in December, but then January, it's like crickets. Now's the time when you need to be planning Valentine's Day in your quarter one.
And maybe a little start your New Year's resolution out correctly type of thing, and go ahead and pass that out to people along with their gift certificates and information you're passing
out. Or fill up your last week of December saying all the relatives are in, escape the stress. And
That's one of our busiest times. Mm-hmm. And we close early, so we don't work the full hours, but people make lots of money. Okay, so what else can I do while I'm sitting around waiting for everybody to come in and buy a gift certificate?
I do like your idea of calling clients, even if they've never bought, just call them, say, thank you so much for being a client. I just wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays. Just doing that, don't sell them anything. Just say, I'm so excited.
Yeah, make a point of not selling them.
Yeah.
They will be so impressed that you're not trying to sell them that they'll buy everything. I do that all the time.
Or it's just reminding them, hey, that you're here. You know, sometimes they just need a reminder, and then they're like, oh yeah, my neck's been hurting.
Yeah. It's so funny you called, because I've been thinking about picking up the phone. And so use your time wisely. So, but I've done all that. What else can I do? How about some holiday parties or some holiday gatherings where you wear an obnoxious looking shirt that says, my hands want your body, or, you know.
Yeah, you got to be careful within this day and age, unfortunately.
Yeah, unfortunately, but
you know what I mean? You know your audience. You know, utilize your friends' parties, honestly, with those ugly sweater parties.
Yeah.
Make it massage theme. Make it spa theme.
And honestly, always, always, always have your little business cards with you saying, I would love to get you a gift card. And, you know, if you don't have time to get to me, I can get it over to you if you're within this radius.
Yeah.
When you're smaller, you do everything you can. When you're larger, no, you tell them to come to you.
Yeah, no.
Or mail it out.
Or
tell them to call you.
Or again, online gift certificates.
Yeah, or, you know, if you don't have online but you're large enough, tell them to call you that you'll
if
just.
You're large enough. And you don't have online.
Well, I'm talking about maybe two therapists that are starting to grow. Okay, they're baby steps here.
All right.
So you log it down and tell them, look, this is the number I want you to put onto your gift certificate. You make one for your loved one.
What is the number that it's now unacceptable for them not to have online gift certificates? Because I've been researching it to get ready for the six pillar program.
Know.
Honestly,
I
have.
Oh my God, this is twice, folks. She's mean to me.
I'm not being mean, but I'm just saying that don't limit that.
Good thing I'm going. the lake house today.
Don't limit yourself just because you're small.
She's right.
Don't limit yourself. There are plenty of programs out there. Gift Card Cafe is great. I talked with Greg over there. He's super, super nice.
See, this is why you need Ramona if you don't have a Ramona in your life. It's because I really am. I'm a little overwhelmed with a lot of this stuff. So I'm like, Mona, I can't handle it. So you're going to have to help me. So if Mona gives you the guidance on the steps of how to do it, you either do it yourself or you get your husband or you get your mama or your sister or your brother and y'all make it happen.
You got to have some accountability. I think that's the difference. And the reason why we've been so successful is, number one, we had financial accountability from the beginning with my dad. That's number one, you know, and that was huge. But number two is that because we've worked together, and it was not easy in the beginning. Let me tell
you. We already said, holy crap. There are so many tears, so much crying, and so much drama.
So much drama. So stupid girl.
But we grew up and took Lexapro.
Yes, a lot of Lexapro.
I'm trying to think of some other cutesy little ideas, but those are really some of your basics. Just the get basics out there and spread the
and
word.
And this is one more thing, guys, with the emails. You need to send emails out. You can't send just one. You have to send multiple emails out. You can't just send one email out. So this is my suggestion is the 12 days leading up to Christmas, send an email out once a day. 12 days of Christmas, my true love gave to me, you know, 12 months of massage. You know, make it really ridiculous and have the links in there too. Again, these are all things we go over in our email course. And I don't mean to try to sell you guys, but we're getting to the point now where we really, really want you to invest in your careers and your businesses. And we just want you guys to be as successful as you want to be, because the holiday season really is your chance to shine. And if you're taking our advice, it means you're going to shine way above any of your competitors, including the Pizza Hut of massage. Ceci, you got anything else for them while we wrap up?
No, I think that we've given you a lot to think about. And once again, on Facebook, reach out to us and we will be there and support you. And just plug at it, folks, and have a smile on your face. Enjoy the holidays. Keep your shirt buttoned up.
And again, if you're going to undrape anything and you're not sure the client understands why, tell them. Tell them first.
Yeah.
Go
back to the basics, unfortunately.
The basics sometimes work. All right. We'll see you guys later. Bye.
Need more actionable steps to get your spa headed in the right direction? Head to spapreneur.com. We've got the tools, tricks, and methods to making your spa as successful as it can be. Spapreneur.com.